My name is Risa Igelfeld. I am 101 and a half. There are two things that stand out on the first day after Hitler's gangs marched in. One, they smashed all the windows of Jewish stores, coming to homes and grabbing the men out of the house to the concentration camps. The other thing was, it was a Sunday morning, it was a Jewish holiday, and I was dressed in the white and red dress and white and red shoes, and I was going to walk to the park. And on the way, there were brown shirts rounding up Jewish girls. Then they asked me, "Are you Jewish?" And I said, "Yes." "You're coming with us to watch the headquarters." There were several brown shirts, and one of them liked me. I was very pretty. And he walked in the back of the others, and he said, "You know, they are saying you're going to wash the headquarters. They're going to tie you to a table, and one after the other will rape you and beat you. But you can get out of it if you meet me tonight at a certain park at 8 o'clock. But if you don't show, I'll come to your house and I'll bang on the door and I'll take you away." And I went inside my house and I told my sister, "Let's get out of here." And we had a maid who, we told her the whole story, what to expect. And he really came to our house and he banged with the boots and then, "Open up!" She opened up, she looked at him and said, "Aren't you ashamed of yourself to make a date with a Jewish girl?" And he took off like lightning, he was never seen again. My husband's sister was my good friend. And one Friday night, it was a rainy night, I bicycled over to her and she said, "I'm so glad you're here. I expect my brother for the weekend and he's always so bored." And I said, "Well, if you have company, I'll go home." She said, "No, please, please stay." So I stayed and that was my future husband. But I didn't like him. I didn't like his English. He was very poor. The following Sunday, he was at my house at the door. "I want to take you out." So we went bicycle riding. We rode it to Windsor. We saw the royal family coming out of chapel, and that was quite exciting. Then we sat down by the River Thames, and he unpacked a beautiful lunch with all the trimmings, and I was impressed. He was from Vienna, and he lived like five blocks from where I lived. His father was an entrepreneur like my father. We had a lot in common. My husband adored him. If he wasn't already there, my husband would say, "Where is he? I don't see. Oh, he's coming, he's coming." And they became like friends. But he fell in love with me right away. One time I walked into the kitchen, and he followed me into the kitchen and he said, "I love you. You make me feel so young. But I'm not a marriage wrecker. I will not say anything or do anything that's not right." And I fell in love with him too. And my husband had one stroke after another and his brain was not functioning, but I kept him at home and didn't send him away into any home. And finally he passed on and Ralph took over at once. How do I start my day? I start with exercises, about 25 minutes of exercises, all kinds, my arms, my legs, my whole body. And then I either wait for the lady who gives me the shower and everything and helps me dress, or I just wash myself from top to bottom. I'm very proud of myself that I can do it. and I dress myself if nobody's here. I can do it a little slower than they would do it, but I do it. Develop the attitude I have, which teaches me to accept whatever happens and to look for blessings. In other words, my attitude is always positive. I was forced to do that by things that were happening to me. But I wasn't going to go under. I was going to go on living and find the sunny side of life. And at my 100th birthday party, which was a very big party, there were 135 people in the big hall, and I got up and sang one song. Enjoy yourselves, you're younger than you think. Enjoy yourselves while you're still in the pink. The years go by as quickly as a wink. Enjoy yourselves, you're younger than you think.